Hello guys, so in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to use this multi-purpose machine called the Groomit machine that is used for beauty enhancement of our clothing in fashion. And this machine can achieve lot, when I mean lot of things, but I just have few of them on the table here. The glass dies, the cover button dies, the pearl dies, and the eyelet dies. So I'll be using all these dies with this single machine to achieve a lot of things in this video. You're welcome back to TBL Couture channel. Thank you for liking. Without further ado, let's get into the video. First set of dies that I'm going to be showing us is the glass dies, or the snap button or pearls dies as they call it. And you can see the handle that we have, this handle that can just press down that string. And we have a hole both under and in between the Groomit machine where we'll be putting our dies. And these are the dies that we'll be using to achieve our pearl button or glass button that we use as a button on our cloth. We have four sets. The first one, which has a white like glass inside it, is used for the button himself. We are going to put the head of the button inside this one, which I'm going to be showing us as we go on in this video. I'll be using this piece of cloth as a sample material to achieve what I want to show you. So I'm going to be taking the first set of the dies, and the screw right here that I'm holding on to, with that screw you can tighten or loosen your hole. You can see that the dies could not enter because I tightened it, and when you loosen it, you'll be able to insert your dies comfortably inside the hole. And this upper part, you can see it has a screw edge. This is what you are going to put at the upper part of the Groomit machine. Both of those dies work together. I'll be taking the first button, which is the glass itself, and I will turn it upside down. That is, the main face that is going to be outside your fabric will be down, while the sharp edge will be up. Then the second one is the pointed one. The pointed one will be inside of the machine at the upper part, while the one that is going to hook with the sharp edge of the glass will be turned directly downward. You're just going to take your piece of fabric and you press it down carefully, like so, with I think a little strength or so, and you can see it has hooked together. This is as simple and easy as it looks. It's not very difficult to achieve. I should refer to it as the hook, and we'll be taking the snap part of the button, which also has its own dies. So I'm going to set this one aside, then insert that of the snap dies, which has a sharp press in and out edge. The upper part of the snap part is just like the first part of the snap part also. So you are going to do the same process by attaching it. Then you will take the one side of the snap part, which has a sharp edge that you should carefully observe. It is that side of that sharp edge that is going to snap with your hook button. It is the smooth part that is going to hook with the other aspect of the snap button. And if you don't get it like that, you can just take your button like that and just hook it together. And whichever one enters that hole, that is what is going to be facing up, because that is not what you are going to hook with the sharp edge of the other side of your button. I made a lot of mistakes, and so you need to be careful, observe very well before going ahead to do this. So you insert it like that, then the sharp edge you turn it face up and insert it like so. You put your fabric in between and press down for you to snap them together. Bring it out and you can see what we have. You can just try it out, hook it together, and it snaps straight up. This is it. You have your pearls button. book together with the plane. It's very simple, easy and neat. The second one is the hollow button, which does not have a glass in it. This is also like the glass button, but the difference between the two is one has a glass and the other one does not have a glass or pearl interchangeably. So you are going to take the hook itself, that is the hook, and just hook it to this upper side of the glass button, which is going to be at the upper side of the machine. The one that it is hooked into now is the same thing as the one that is presently inside the machine. So you just go ahead and hook it and take the sharp edge of the other one, turn it up and put your fabric in between and just go ahead to press down and it will snap immediately. So you can see it has snapped, it's not removable, it has stuck together, except you use force to remove it. That is when it's going to remove in itself. You can see the same as a hook, but at the outside part, one has a glass pearl and the other one has a plain one, while the snap on its own has a plain one. You can hook the plain and plain together, which is the hollow one, and you can hook the pearl or glass together with the plain, which is the pearl or glass button. This is as easy and as simple as it goes. So the second one I'm going to be showing us is how to use the grommet machine with the cover button dies. I have the bigger case of the cover button, which is I think 45, and then I have the smaller one of 35 thereabouts. Then I have all the five sets of the dies, from the biggest to the smallest size of the dies, that is from 50 to 45 to 35 to 30, and the last one is 20. I have all these five sets of dies which I'm going to be teaching you how to use with this grommet machine. But let's say for instance you put your dies into the grommet machine and you use the cover to cover it up, then when you go ahead to press it down, you can see that the head that is being pressed down is not touching the head of your dies button. This is not going to be possible, it's because it's too short for the dies button. But with the help of our pearl button dies, we can achieve our cover button. We are going to be using the upper part of the pearl dies to achieve this. I'm just going to be needing one of that upper part of the pearl dies, and with this I'm going to show you how to achieve your cover button. The first thing you will do is just to insert it into the screw like so, and just go ahead to tighten it firmly into it. Once this is done, you can go ahead to confirm if it will work out or not. You can see it's pressed firmly on the cover button dies, and now we are good to go. What I'm going to do is set those three aside, and I'm going to be using size 45 and size 30 just to try it out for us. You take a piece of fabric, cut it out, a small piece, cut it out, then open it up and you insert it firmly inside your cover button dials. But if you discover your fabric is quite big, you can still trim it off and you go ahead to insert the metal part of the cover button piece and just go ahead to close it like so. Then you close it up just the way I did and turn it upside down. You turn it upside down, take it to your grommet machine. You can hold it down with your hand if you like and just press like so with a little force. Press with a little force and we've achieved our cover button. You can see the way the cover button is firm, and if you just touch that aspect of it to try to pull it out, it won't be pulled out. That is the first one. I'm just going to go quickly ahead to show you the second one, which is almost the same thing, but you can observe that there is one deeper side, that is one side of our cover button pearl is deeper than the other side. It is at that deeper one that you insert whatever you want to insert. Just go through the first process, turn it upside down, press down your machine with a little force And voila, here we have our cover button ready to be used. This is how you make your cover button with the Gromit machine. So the third one I'm going to be showing us is how to use our eyelet dies. And this is what I used for this bracket corset that I'm showing you right here in this video. I have two sets of eyelet dies. I'll be using the first one, which is the one that is commonly used for our corset. Is the bigger one, I think size 22 or so. And I'm going to go ahead and screw the part that has a screw at the top of my Gromit machine, and the one without a screw that is pressing up and down, and put it inside the hole at the down part. Then I'm going to go ahead to just have a little cut, like a notch. I have my puncher, but it's not as sharp, so I'm using the scissors. Then I'll take the piece of the dies, put it, turn it upside down, put it like so, where the hole is notched on my fabric, insert it inside. Then I'll take the cover, which is a flat piece of gold metal, and put it to cover it up like so, and just press down my Gromit machine, the head of the Gromit machine, like so, and it is hooked. Just look at it. It is fast, smooth, and neat. So you have your eyelet for the corset. This is mostly used for bags and corset, just like the way I have it on the bra cups corset I'm showing you right now. You can see it has the same outlook. Then I'll go ahead to show us the smaller one. This is very small. I mostly use it for belt hooks, so that I can use my belt hook for it. Then I'll go ahead to have a very tiny notch, very tiny, and just go through the same first process that I did. This one does not have a cover, it's just as plain as that, but I can bet you it's very nice and neat once you use it. And it has another set again that is the smallest one. It's like I have the bigger, the medium, and the smallest one. There's still the biggest, but I don't use the biggest one. So you have like three set of eyelets fixed on the fabric. That is the way you use these eyelet dies. The last one I'll be showing you is the pearl dies. I have four set of pearl dies, from the biggest size to the medium size to the smaller size to the smallest size. I have those set of dies with me right now, but the pearl size of what I have is for the medium size of the dial, so that is what I'm going to be using. For the second part of the dies, that is where you put your pearl hook. It's going to make your pearl hook to the fabric. This is very small, and that you can see the hole where I'm going to insert it into is also small. Then you put your hook carefully inside that hole, just like the way I'm doing, and go ahead to put it inside your Gromit machine. And when putting the pearl, also do not dip it too much inside that place, because it's not going to come out when after hooking it to the fabric. Just put it carefully, go ahead and hook it into your machine, then put your fabric in between and press the hand of your machine downward. Then you pull it out, and you can see what we have here. It worked. I'm just going to do another one for us, just to show us. Go through that first process and you have your pearl with you. So these are what you can use your Gromit multi-purpose machine to achieve. You have your cover button dies, which you can use to achieve your cover button. You also have your highlight dies that you can use to achieve your highlights. And you have your glass button or pearl button dies to achieve your glass button or pearl button, and also to achieve your hollow button. And finally, you have your pearl dies to achieve your pearl. One can achieve all this with just using this multi-purpose Gromit machine. It has so many more dies, but these are the dies that I have, and it has been very useful to me. And so we've come to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it and you're able to learn one or two things from this video. Please subscribe, I'm begging you. Leave your thoughts in the comment section. Turn the notification bells for more videos that come in. Till next time, bye bye.